that he will attack in full force. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear respected brothers and sisters, honorable listeners, Allah has clearly stated in the Quran that shaitan, the devil, is our enemy. Inna shaitan lil-insani aduwwun mubin. And Allah has also commanded us, fattakhidhuhu aduwa, that we make him as our enemy. And the objective of the enemy is always to give us harm, to attack us. And shaitan will attack us. Every step in our life, he will try to find opportunities of different ways of attacking us. And he has described this inside the Quran. When he was told to leave Jannah, he asked Allah for opportunity, for a long life till Qiyamah, so he can misguide humanity. In there, he explained the way he is going to attack each and every single one of us. He said, ثُمَّ لَآتِيَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ أَيْمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شَمَائِلِهِمْ وَلَا تَجْدُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. He said that every single human, I will attack him. How will I attack him? I will attack him from front. I will attack him from behind. I will attack him from the right side. And I will attack him from the left. Allah, he had mentioned these four angles. Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahmatullahi alayhi has given main two interpretations of this verse. The first interpretation is that this is a ta'abir, an explanation that he will attack in full force. Is a metaphor, is a way of explaining something, that he will attack in full force. Thus he has explained and mentioned these four directions. The second interpretation which Imam Razi rahimahullah has given, that when shaitan told Allah that he will attack every human from these four directions, what this meant is that when he will direct from front, it means that all the stages which will come in the future, the life after death, the life of the grave, the reckoning, the questioning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, he will insert doubts in our minds regarding the future. This is when he will attack from front. And when he will attack from behind, what does this mean? This means as a person grows older, he will put extreme love of wealth, family, house, job inside his heart, which ultimately will become the means of destruction and will divert his attention for preparing for the life after death. That's why the Prophet ﷺ said, يَحْرُمْ ابْنِ آدَمْ, that the son of Adam becomes old. وتشب منه اثنان, but two things always remain young, الحرص على المال والحرص على العمر, أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, greed for wealth and greed for age. Person goes older, but his greed also increases for these two things. May Allah save us. And when he will attack from right, this means that he will attack the pious people, those people who are trying to adopt the deen. He will indulge them in certain sins which will destroy their good deeds. And attacking from the left, this means he will call us and invite us towards general sins, fornication, lying, cheating. Imam Razi has mentioned inside his tafsir that when the angels, when they had observed this, that shaitan has taken an oath that he will attack every single one of us in these four directions, they showed their sympathy for the son of Adam. And they asked Allah, that, O Allah, how will this person survive? How can we survive in such an environment where we are attacked and our iman is getting bombarded on every step we take? Allah said that he's mentioned these four directions, but he never mentioned fawq and tahat, above and beneath. Therefore, any male and female who prostrates in front of me by lowering his head down, and after salah raises hands and asks for forgiveness, I will forgive all his sins. All the efforts that shaitan made in misguiding and misleading this person, by repenting once to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the efforts of shaitan will go to waste. That's why, my brothers and sisters, sincere advice is that we carry on trying. We carry on trying. whether we make sin every single day, we carry on repenting. The Prophet ﷺ said, "At-ta'ib min adh-dhanb kaman la dhanba lahu aw kama qal," that a person who repents from sin is though he has not even committed that sin. May Allah keep us steadfast on Iman, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all death on Iman. Wa akhiru da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.